Hi, I'm Joseph Calloway.
Hi, I'm Joanne Calloway, and we are Those Calloways.
So today we're going to talk about something different.
Really different.
Yes, Joanne wants to talk about Tiffany and Company.
I just want to share with you what a wonderful, wonderful company it is and how much joy we've had having them in our lives.
And they like us very much. Joanne likes them very much.
I do. That's yes. As a matter of fact.
And there's nothing like a little blue box with white ribbon. And Joanne wanted to always thank our clients. When we finish a transaction at the close of escrow, we give what's called a closing gift.
Absolutely.
And we also give one oftentimes to the agent on the other side. It was somebody that we didn't know before. Sometimes it's agents that, you know.
Oh, it's about 95% of the time it's agents, right.
But sometimes it's the second or third time we've given them
absolutely. A gift. They deserve it.
But it's always the little blue box because it says a lot more than here's a tape
Joseph,
recorder.
Joseph, you're stuttering. It's because you are ridiculous.
Well, I could tell the story about Tom Brokaw when he was a young reporter. He told this story years ago. He was assigned to the White House when Lyndon Johnson was there. And Lyndon Johnson had a policy each year, beginning of the year, he'd sit with his secretary and decide on what his official gift was. And he would give that gift that year anytime he wanted to give a gift of appreciation. It was that same gift. And Tom Brokaw got his first one the first year. It was a tape recorder, battery-operated tape recorder. These were very big back in the 60s. So he got the tape recorder, and it was appreciation for something. And a few months later, they were in some sort of a ceremony, and he got another tape recorder. He opened it up, and he started to say something about, oh, you already gave me one of these. And the whole press corps turned white, and they all said, no.
Don't say anything.
That's his gift. You know, you might get several this year. But anyway, hopefully that's not what happens with us. But we do give out Tiffany gifts. And we've been doing it for a long time since we started in the business.
Over 20 years.
23 now. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes.
So
that's because you just off camera or off whatever we're on.
Microphone. Off microphone. Right. How are you off microphone?
You just corrected me again for the 27th time.
No problem.
Okay, go ahead, Joseph.
So anyway, I want to tell the story about this was about a year and a half ago.
No, it was longer than that.
2 years ago.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. About 2 years ago, we went to New York on a different matter, and we were in there. We always go, whenever we go to New York, we try to
Fifth
get
Avenue.
To New York as often as possible, but sometimes it's more than once a year, and sometimes it's 2 years, 3 years between. But anyway, we always stay at the Carlisle.
Mm-hmm. Hotel.
72nd in Madison, I think. Yeah.
Something very
something
close.
Like that.
Right.
It's
wonderful.
Hotel.
And they just remodeled.
Yes. Had lunch with Vera Wang there.
Well, Joseph, you did. Now, you were the only person in the restaurant.
Well, she didn't know we were having lunch with her. She was at the other table.
Joseph, that was hysterical.
Anyway.
I will never let him talk to anyone, you know, when it's not someone we know, and then I drag him out of the thing.
Yes. Well, her store is about two blocks down from the hotel, and she walks in, she's on her cell phone talking about weddings, and I'm thinking, you know, I think that's Vera Wang, and then some woman in the it was a tea room, and some other woman came over to her and talked about her wedding and blah, blah, blah. And so, sure enough, it was Vera Wang.
Yes, that's pleased you ever since.
I did. I took a stealth shot with
I'm thrilled for you,
She didn't
Joseph.
Know I took a photo.
Right.
But anyway.
Something really nifty did happen at that lunch was when we went to Tiffany's.
That trip.
This was so neat to me, I can't tell
on
you.
On that trip, we went to Tiffany's because Joanne said, oh, we got to go to Tiffany's, see if there's anything new. The items that we give are from the third floor.
They have their
home department. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they have wine glasses and china and crystal and all sorts of wonderful things. And so we went to Tiffany's.
We
and, did. We skipped the first floor. The first floor is...
No, not Joseph.
No,
you will never see Joseph on the first
They talk carrots and thousands and... No. So we go to the...
I have none of those, incidentally.
But we took the elevator to the third floor and...
the home department.
Yes. And so we the first person that came up, we said we wanted to look at a few things. And she inquired from here. And we said, no, we're from Arizona. And we mentioned our name. And when we mentioned our name,
fun.
It was really cute because she kind of, she said, oh, I'll be right back. And she came back in about 3 or 4 minutes and she introduced the manager.
No, it was longer, but go ahead.
Well, anyway, she introduced the manager of the home department up there. I always said, that's nice. Nice to meet
Incidentally,
you.
Let me, before I forget to tell you, if you had the privilege of purchasing anything there, they had to have the finest team on earth. They were always so kind, always so polite. They were really absolutely wonderful to work with.
They are. They mm-hmm. are a credit to retail. Their training is incredible because they all know all the rules and they can all tie that bow.
They can, is, yeah, yes,
they,
right.
They actually have a bow
can
class.
Can you tie it now?
I can't. But they
no,
have a bow tying class so that you can tie that mm-hmm. white ribbon just perfectly.
So this young lady.
We were with this lady, and she said, you know, you are our number one client. And
Josephine.
You know, I looked around to see who she was
so
talking
funny.
To. And I said, well, what do you mean? And she said, well, in terms of units, you've bought more units from our department over the last
that
years.
That was the home department.
From the home mm-hmm. department. She says, we don't have anybody else who's bought nearly as many things. I, of course, had to do the research, and when we got back, I called our local Tiffany gentleman. I asked him if he could find out from our records, you know, how many units and all that sort of thing. At that time, we had spent over $225,000 with Tiffany's over the years. So I'm sure we're over $250,000 by now. And
we thought it was fortune, didn't we?
We thought it was mm-hmm. quite a bit, yes.
So. But what we did with them for years and years and years and years now, when clients have close of escrows, I send them a lovely package from Tiffany and Company. And I've never gotten one back. I love to deliver them myself because the people are just that you can hear them just happy.
The point of it of this is clients choose us and we are grateful for that. In business you have to have an attitude of gratitude.
Oh, Joseph, that's nice.
Every now and then. But when it comes to buying a home or selling a home, they're in that point in their life where everything becomes, you know, well, when the house sells, we'll do this, or, well, we need to get this done before the house sells, or what. They're kind of in a limbo period of time, and they entrust us to get them through that. And for that trust, we are truly appreciative. We also use the Tiffany gifts for the Salvation Army. We've done a number of conventions
mm-hmm,
that
right.
the Salvation Army gets booths now at the different real estate conventions. We go there and talk to agents about the real estate programs that we have, Real Estate Wednesday and Real Estate for Rehabilitation. When we go there, we always bring about a dozen or so Tiffany boxes.
Absolutely.
You know, with different sizes.
Yes.
And we put them on a display in front of the booth. And
then we get the attention.
Yeah. People are, you know, put your business card in and for a Tiffany drawing. And then we draw a few names each day. And then we call them up and they come and they're always so thrilled. When I work the aisle, I call it bait. I'll take one of the boxes from the display and I'll just hold it up in the air and I'll make eye contact with any of the women walking by. And it's just like, you know, they come straight over. You know?
I'm his wife and you think I believe that, don't you?
Yeah. Well, right. I'm
mm-hmm.
just saying.
Yes, Joseph.
I'm
yes.
just saying anybody sees
right.
that blue box.
No more.
It just comes
no
straight
more.
Over.
No more Tiffany's for you, buddy.
So that helped
right.
that helped
You're good
us.
For the, for the bill.
That helped us with our totals, I'm sure. It's wonderful to create something that's a trademark or a signature item, distinguishes you from others or people know immediately. And I think that people who do business with us, a lot of them think you're the ones that give Tiffany. Nobody else gives Tiffany, at least not anybody that I've known. And so
it's a privilege. It really is, Joseph. It's a privilege and a wonderful, wonderful opportunity.
Yes. They made sunglasses.
It's houseware. Yeah.
They made sunglasses for a while.
You don't want to know how much they are. Okay. So let's continue on, Joseph, because I try and keep your heart, in the right place.
There's a pleasure in giving, whether it's charitable giving or business giving. The joy is in the giving.
It really is. The giving, of course.
Yes. So that's our Tiffany story. If you want to get a Tiffany gift, give us a call and do some business.
Yes, we'll sell your home. Thank
so you. If you're looking to buy or sell Arizona real estate, give us a call at 480-596-5751. Or you can go to our website, thosecalloways.com. Thank you for listening.
You.